You need to check this out. Headline, Jesuit Magazine Makes Catholic Case for Communism. The article says this. The Jesuit flagship publication in the United States, America Magazine, has published an article defending Marxism and comparing the murderous atheist ideology to Christianity in the Catholic Case for Communism. America writer Dean Detloff says that the militant atheism of Marxist politics is understandable because Christianity has so often been a force allied to the ruling powers that exploit the poor. Communists, on the other hand, are loving people, concerned above all for the good of the poor. The Jesuits' decision to publish a radical article of this sort suggests that they believe public opinion is warming toward communism. America's editors have floated a weather balloon to see how Americans react to communism 2.0. Now, as I've done previously during this video series I'm doing, exposing the Open Synod of the Seventh-day Adventist leaders, I have to take a slight detour now and again regarding something that just happened in the news that is prophetic in nature when it comes to Satan gathering his anti-Christian troops that will soon go forth against God's people at Armageddon. Herein lies the craftiness of Satan, in fact. For centuries, he had Roman Catholic leaders torture and kill innocent people while at the same time claiming the popes were Christians while doing this. Satan did this through the popes with the sole purpose in mind of using the evil past of the Catholic Church as if it was the past of real Christians today so as to fan the flames of hatred for Christians in these last days. This hatred is a must if Armageddon is ever to work for him. As we already see, the media hating on Christians all over the world now on a daily basis, and we also know the Vatican was actually built by Satan for this purpose, and every prelate in Rome has been recently exposed as card-carrying devil worshippers, just as prophecy predicted long ago. What was just released to the worldwide media via these Jesuits needs to be addressed. As we all know, the Pope is a Jesuit. And as evil as all the popes have been, this current pope is without a doubt one of the worst, if not the worst. And so it is to be expected that his Jesuit brethren will declare to all the world that Christians were very evil in the past so as to cultivate more hatred towards real Christians. Because, as we all know, Catholicism has been proven time and time again over the centuries to be anything but Christianity, and the sole purpose of Catholicism was to make Christianity look evil all along. In fact, many of the Vatican prelates have declared openly, in writing no less, that they are in fact pagans, and they have adopted pagan theology and just given it Christian names. Real Christians never killed anyone over the centuries because the loving and meek Holy Spirit that moves them to emulate Jesus Christ within moves them to love and not hate their fellow man, as the Vatican prelates have done time and time again in very torturous manner. The historic fact here is that it was the Vatican that killed hundreds of millions of Christians during the Inquisition, as well as exploiting the poor all along. The Jesuits are simply blaming Christians for what they did to pull the onus off of them so as to place it on the real Christians for the sole purpose of gathering all the world against us on that great and dreadful day. In fact, this is why Muslims hate Christians to this day. They actually think it was Christians that attacked and slaughtered them during the Crusades, when all along it was the Catholic popes that slaughtered the Muslims. That's historic fact. There are so many historic records, in fact, confirming all this that the Vatican had no choice but to apologize under Pope John Paul II, which was, in fact, as we all know, a disingenuous apology on March 12, 2000, called his mea culpa. And by the way, that apology was prophesied to occur. But you will not realize this as much as you need if you're using the edited Spirit of Prophecy books offered by the Seventh-day Adventist leaders. But you will find info like this in great detail in the original 1884 version of the Great Controversy offered at vbates.com. As also prophesied, though, and as many of my recent videos have proven over the past few months, the Seventh-day Adventist Church is in bed with Rome, right up to them sending the tithe of the SDA people to the Pope. And as for real Christians exploiting the poor, as these Jesuits claim, no, that too is a lie. Real Christians are very giving, as just about every soul that has ever been in need discovered about them over the eons. But the fact the Catholic Church won't sell one of the hundreds of thousands of priceless items in the Vatican, or all their cathedrals to feed the poor, proves hands down that they do not have the love of Jesus in them. They could literally feed every hungry soul on earth for years by selling just one statue or one painting in the churches of Rome, but they have never, nor ever, will do that. And so why is this Jesuit Pope and his friends concentrating on trying to make communism appear to be the better option for all of us on earth? Why does he claim there is a Catholic case for communism? Well, it's because the Catholic Church is based on a communistic cult mindset. In fact, I proved this in this video years ago. And to further confirm that this is their long prophesied agenda, have you seen my Vatican's socialist agenda page over the years? If not, it's high time you did. The Pope knows, as does every prelate in Rome, you cannot enforce the mark of the beast without a socialistic form of government. And so this is why socialism has been the talk of the town in all political circles the last few years, especially right here in America, because that's where the mark of the beast is going to be enforced first. And as I also proved in a video I did some time ago, Rome controls every politician and every CEO on earth already. And so this is why they echo Rome's agenda for them. And yes, this is also why every U.S. president must meet with the Pope after each election, even if he wins a second term. The basic reality is that even our president, right here in America, must do as the man of sin commands in these last days, just as prophecy predicted. The mark is soon to be enforced, and the real Christians, and you know who you are, you need to get busy doing what prophecy said is your duty to do today. Thank you for watching. God bless.